eDigital Africa Media presents Everything Digital with Faith History. And now, Faith History.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another exciting episode of the Everything Digital Africa show. I'm your host, Faith History, and I will be your digital guide as always, as I've been for the past, 5 years? I don't know, man. I'm not tired. Are you? I hope you're not. Anyway, today we're going to be giving you a step-by-step guide to creating a killer pitch deck. Now, this is going to be very useful for you if you are an SME, if you are a creative with your own business and you constantly find the need to, apply for opportunities, or you're looking for investors, or you're just looking for new clients, you need a pitch deck. If you don't know what a pitch deck is, or if you are wondering if you even need one at all, then let's quickly hold off a second and define what it is. Now, a pitch deck is a brief marketing presentation, emphasis on brief. Now, don't make it like 30 pages. I mean, nobody has time for that. Let's make it about, 10 slides, So PowerPoint slides, and it could be also in PDF format, but the catch is that it has to be visual, right? Like, so don't just put a bunch of words explaining everything you do. Also put in some nice photos and graphics, infographics if possible, so that, it becomes interesting and visually in about, 15 minutes or less, someone can quickly grasp a great idea of what you do and who you do it for and why you do it and how you do it. Right? So it is great for physical meetings or online meetings, even to talk about your business plan, to entice potential investors into listening to you more, to get customers to sit up and pay attention to your services, or prospective partners, or even co-founders. A pitch deck simply helps you tell a compelling story about your business. So if you're seeking financing again from an investor, a partnership from another business, or you're looking just for a big client to come on board, you will definitely need to master getting your pitch deck together. All right. Now, if you've listened to our previous episode about the media kits and you're wondering what's the difference between a pitch deck now and a media kit, it's simple. Media kits are great for creatives and influencers to highlight, what they do. And it's usually, a couple pages, a couple slides, it's not a long thing. While a pitch deck is more, it's more in depth. It's great, when you're pitching your business, yourself as a business, and you're really offering like services that go even beyond what one would offer with a media kit. So that's the difference in my mind. It's like a pitch deck is more detailed, more business to business, while a media kit is more, hey, look, you wanna run an ad with us? You wanna see, who we are in like a couple slides? Then that's a media kit, all right? So sometimes you need both. We have both at eDigital Africa. We have media kits. We have several pitch decks that we use, depending on who we're pitching to and what we're pitching about. We have different templates. So you should start trying to create your templates for your own business. It's widely believed, though, that a pitch deck should be about just 10 slides long, and for good reasons. You don't want to bore the people or the person that you are presenting to. So keep it brief. The sweet spot for your slide should be about 15 to 20 minutes. So now let's get into it. Now that I've, gingered you and sold you on why you need a pitch deck, what it's for, let's go into how to create your first pitch deck and what information should be in there. Which slide should carry what? How should you arrange the information on the slides? I'll be telling you all of this in a minute, right after this break. Hey, investor, the African business landscape is so ripe with amazing new business opportunities and solutions right now. And we've just finished an amazing go-to-market strategy for an investor here at eDigital Africa. They were interested in how viable the company they wished to invest in was. So if you're an investor or you have an interest in a company, but you're not sure if you should put your money there, then we'd love to help you do the research and decide. Also, if you're a founder and you're planning to launch your own app or platform soon, then reach out to us. We'd love to help you with your digital marketing strategy. Just send us an email, everythingdigitalng@gmail.com. Welcome back. I'm going to be talking now about the easy steps to creating a killer pitch deck, and my focus is for investors. All right, so if you're looking to get more money for your business, then listen to this. Now, the problem. All right, so number one, you've got to identify what the problem is. What problem are you solving with your product? In marketing, this is known as the pain point. As the introduction to your pitch, this is where you will explain why your product or service exists. You have to then describe the critical problem that it solves. This problem plays a major role in grabbing the attention of investors. If you describe the problem accurately, you'll be able to connect with your audience by touching on a problem that they've experienced in their own lives. So, here is a pointer. Clearly define the target audience's frustration. So use statistics and observations. How did you realize this frustration? Be a storyteller. You can even share your own experience. Focus on the common factor. You were spurred to create a solution because you saw the problem affecting others as well. Does this problem apply only to a specific group, or is it a broader issue? Answer those questions. And it could just be a line, it could be a paragraph, to just be your intro about the problem, right? And then number two, the solution. Where there's a problem, there's a solution. And you're the solution, I hope, and your business is the solution. So in this section, you want to highlight the features of your product or service and show how it works. So you have to know your market and how the value of your product fits into this market. How do you plan to solve the problems you've outlined? Is there already a solution to the problem? Or is the problem that the existing solutions aren't good enough? Let me give you a key factor. Know your competitors and what they are doing. This way you can outline why alternative solutions fail and how you can eliminate these failures. Once you identify your unique value proposition, you can highlight these benefits to investors. Let me repeat that. Know your competitors and what they are doing. All right. So if you know your competitors, what they're doing and why the solutions don't work, you can just highlight it. You don't have to go deep into it. Just highlight it and say, look, these are the kind of solutions that are here in the marketplace already. They're failing and I have a better solution. Now, one thing to remember, though, is that your idea may sound innovative, but the feasibility is the most important factor. Higher feasibility will result in higher interest in investors. Number three, your value proposition. Now that you've underlined the problem and solution, it's time to reveal your unique value proposition. You should have a compelling message that explains why you are worth investing in. What do you do? What's your promise to consumers? What stands out about the product you provide? Bear in mind that to use a simple language, meaning that, it should be very clear and understandable. So you might be like you're selling something that's very technical, it's a solution, and for the average layman, they might not understand it. Even your investor might not understand it. So you need to be able to define and use simple words so that anybody can understand it. A six-year-old should be able to understand it, okay? That's how simple your pitch deck should be and your solutions and your explanations. All right. So don't think that, this is when I must sound so complicated and smart. And, they will now think that I'm very smart and that they will now buy. If they can't understand it, they already tuned off and they're moving on to the next opportunity. Okay. Number four, competition. So you know how I mentioned your competition before? Well, I want to expand on that because your pitch deck will include a segment talking about the other people who are also doing what you're doing. So here you will need to examine other companies in the market. How are they dealing with the same problem? What's their solution? And where does your product or service fit into the scenario? The best way to draw the scheme of competition in investor minds and to demonstrate it with clarity is to use visuals. So put your facts and research together before you present them in your pitch deck. And if you check the show notes, we'll have shared, you know, a couple of, you know, slides and graphics that you can use, you know, or examples of what, you know, that slide could look like. All right. Now, number five, competitive advantages. After displaying the competition, indicate the unique factors that give your company a competitive edge. What will set you apart and how did you define these advantages? For instance, you can go into like, you know, which unique features does your product or service have? What's the adoption rate? Are you the first product on the market that's solving the issue? Are you solving an old issue in a completely new and innovative way? What does your pricing model look like? Will it align with the target audience's budget? How do you utilize technology? Will you now or in the future consider potential partnerships? All these elements will prove the strength of your market research. Now, if you know these factors, you'll be more convincing and able to answer possible questions investors might have without any hesitation. All right? It's not that you're going to be perfect. It's just that you are prepared, right? Remember, done is better than just thinking about it. Okay, so now, number six, market validation and traction. Use key metrics such as monthly active users, average revenue per user, profit margins. Showing all these key metrics will prove that you are realistic in your approach and ready to establish your company further. Now, if you do, if you're pre-launch or do not have a minimum viable product yet, you may want to replace this slide with a progress or timeline slide that just illustrates what you've done so far and what's to come. You could also use financial predictions based on your business model, but keep in mind that to be able to raise funds, you will need a strong business model that assures financial success. Again, check the show notes and you can see some examples of what a slide like this could look like, right? With the graphics and the visuals. Number seven, your team. Let's talk about your team. Now, this slide could easily be overlooked, but really, investors don't invest in just the ideas. They invest in you, the human beings behind the ideas. So who are the people putting their blood, sweat, and tears into making this venture work? The investors want to see that. The team is passionate and experienced. They want to know that the team can deliver. It's not a one-person game. You will need a strong team of people who are in this together and ready to put their efforts and common goals towards the company's future. So showcase their background and how they joined this journey. And now for the main event. You've talked about your competition. You've talked about your solutions. You've talked about the problem. You've talked about your team. Let's now do the ask. You have to ask. What's the ask, guys? This is why the whole deck was put together. It will not be a pitch without this segment. Time to score the investment and help your idea grow. So what does this venture need to achieve the goals you listed on this deck? What would solve your company's financial issues and get operations started or advance them? Clearly state why this particular amount is needed. Outline how long this amount will sustain your future actions. Explain where the investment will be spent using graphs. Include a timeline to show the company's next big steps. This is very important. I cannot stress this enough. I've seen so many pitch decks that just don't have the ask. Doesn't say why the amount is needed. Doesn't outline how long this amount will sustain future actions, you know, because your investors aren't just like, you know, unending banks of money. They want to know how long is this going to last for, you know, and then explain where the investment will be used and spent using graphs. Okay. So use a timeline to just show the company's next big steps. And this also forces you to also really think through, you know, what do you need this money for? Lastly, regularly update your pitch deck. And, you know, make sure that the core elements of your company, you know, while they stay the same, you know, you're updating your values, dates, images as your company evolves. You know, your pitch deck is adaptable. It can and should be repurposed, revisited, and revised to suit your evolving needs. You can always add, delete, and move your modules and sections around to adapt the pitch deck as you need it. Now, let's talk quickly before we go about some tools to help you design your pitch deck. Now, I've told you what to put in it. I haven't told you how to put it in there and, you know, what tools to use. So here are some websites that you can check out for amazing templates and inspiration to design your own pitch deck. Canva, of course, Canva comes first. Slidesgo.com, pitchdeckexamples.com, slidebean.com, bplans.com, template.net, PowerPointify.com. Now check out some of these websites and you'll get hundreds of free templates to choose from. And as always happens, you might just find that template that you're like, ah, this is it. And then it's like, you have to pay for it. So if you need to pay for it, or, you know, you're just like, ah, I don't want to be bothered with all this. It just feels too overwhelming. And you want someone to design for you, reach out to us over at eDigital Africa by sending us an email, everythingdigitalng@gmail.com. And we would love to help you with your pitch deck. All right, this is one of our services. We can help you with that. And that's a show for us today. I loved bringing it to you as always. You know, I love you guys and I love helping you and bringing you these amazing ideas and helping you just outline just the best ideas for your business and, you know, digital marketing. And I mean, I've done this for the past, I don't know, almost 20 years. Oh, 20 years. I'm getting old though. And, you know, I first started working on pitch decks myself when I was in my early 20s, my first company. Fact I had with a partner who lives in LA now. And yeah, you know, from that time, I started learning about pitch decks. And then when I got into advertising proper, that's when I knew like, ah, okay, this is like a skill to have. So, you know, it's not something that you should beat yourself up about if you don't know how to do one properly, or if you don't know how to do one that looks pretty and has the information. It's a skill. It's an acquired skill, you know, and I hope that at least you'll start and you'll give yourself a chance to at least start with a shell of it. And if you get stuck again, you can email us at everythingdigitalng@gmail.com. Now, if you love this content and you want to support us to keep doing this, bring you amazing tips and how to's, you can now find us on Patreon at patreon.com/eDigitalAfrica. Again, that's patreon.com/eDigitalAfrica. Please support us to enable us to continue creating the amazing content you love so much. Thank you to all our loyal listeners. We appreciate you. And please, if there's anything you'd like to learn, send us a voice note on the link in the description or via email, everythingdigitalng@gmail.com. Guys, make sure that you're signed up to our newsletter. It comes out weekly, twice a week, and it's chock full of great information as well as fun information. So make sure that you are doing that. And if you want to join that mailing list, again, you can send an email simply to everythingdigitalng@gmail.com. everythingdigitalng@gmail.com. And just put in the subject line, join your mailing list, right? You know, that's it. That's the show for today, guys. Thanks for listening. Please share with your friends and loved ones. And if you haven't already, please subscribe wherever you get your podcast. Stay healthy, stay digital, stay blessed. And goodbye for now, guys, from your girl, Faith History. Toodles.
For more on this topic, visit www.edigitalafrica.com. And follow us on Facebook and Instagram.
The Everything Digital Show is brought to you by eDigital Africa. This is a Faith History production.